testing. Somebody would be more than willing to volunteer to take a walk outside and ask everybody to come inside. There are chairs. I prepared this fantastic speech, and others have also. This is what it's all about. So if you hear me out there, can you please ask everybody to come in? I know you don't want to. Zalman, just... I'm waiting. Louder? Loud? Ooh. Yaakov. Outside. There's like 300 people standing outside, so... You hear me? Alright, Rabbeisai, if everyone could please find the seat. There are a bunch of seats over here. There are a bunch of seats, I believe, in the back. Sit on someone's lap, whatever. Is that it? Okay. Chaim, everybody. I really, really, really hate speaking in public. I'm much better on the phone, drain you a cup. But welcome everybody to the second annual Yalde Barbecue to benefit this most amazing organization, Yalde Shluchei HaRebbe, which is providing support and assistance to over 170 families of shluchim worldwide, not just in the United States, not just in Canada, not just in Eretz Yisrael, Europe, Asia, South America. And I would love to give you the rundown, but I hope most of you know what it is, what we're doing. And the Davish's Hill, with the speakers that are going to follow me, in case you don't know, you'll have a better picture of what we are doing. As well as I'd like to encourage everybody, first of all, there are amazing raffles on the my right side for those who would like to go to a ball game Thursday afternoon at 1:05. I can definitely use that. Yankees, A's, Legend Seeds, kosher food, all that. We have a nice selection of mashke. Everybody can use that. There's a nice gift certificate for Reserve Cut. If anybody hasn't been there, the steak. It's a certain steak, which is actually phenomenal. So get yourself a ticket, a couple tickets, 5 tickets, 10 tickets, CrossFit. We're living with the times, it's all good. So please, after this is all said and done, I hope you can walk over to the raffle stations and buy a couple of raffles. So again, a grace and thanks for everybody for coming. Your time, your money, your presence is greatly appreciated by myself, by the entire Moisid and Yasher Koyach. There are a number of people which I would like to thank before we get on with the program. Number one, I would like to thank Mayor Cohen. A grace and thanks. They say the veal chops and the lamb were out of this world, so... Grace and Dank. Marlia Martin, she's not here. I don't think she's here, but the lady who set up this entire event, inside, outside, the lights, the lighting, the sound, everything. God bless you. These guys, the Mezamrim Chevra from Williamsburg. Let's give it up for the Mezamrim. And the Echfashtei, once this program is the official program, we're going to be treated to a special treat. So look forward to that. Family is extremely important. Everybody knows that the support that you get from your parents, your in-laws, your brothers, your sisters, your brothers-in-laws, your sisters-in-laws is extremely important. So I wanted to give a grace and thank to my dear father that's here, to my dear Shver, my brothers-in-law, my brothers, my brother Mayor who came all the way from Toronto today. What's going on? Am I hearing things? You want me to move back? So thank you everybody for your support, for your encouragement. It means a lot to me. I cannot do it without you. So Ms. Zuck, that there's a saying, it takes a village to raise a child. To put together such a phenomenal event, it's not just one person. And Baruch Hashem, I was lucky enough to gather together a group of chevra which committed themselves to schlepping their friends, to schlepping the family. I will read them off as they in one after the other. Save your applause, but here we go. Mayor Lax, Yisrael Kramer, Akiva Zisolt, Levi Chitrik, who's not here, he's in the Chveis Yena Ekvelt, he's enjoying himself. My dear brother-in-law, David New, all the way from Florida, was able to gather a table together from his shul, after he's dying. Yisrael Kugel, Shmuel Yaxerud, Zalmi Duchvin, if you're there hiding. Nachanan Shigalov, a big thank and a big shout out to Shaul Dahan and the entire team at New Orleans. You guys are absolutely fantastic. A great thank. Yisrael Willow, Levi Goldstein, who was this entire idea, is here, so all the credit to you. Binyamin Levin, Zalman Skablom. I know I delayed you a couple enough times, but I appreciate for your patience and everything that you do for us. Mandy Kitlarski, where's Mandy Kitlarski? It's not just Mandy Kitlarski, I appreciate everything that you do personally, but it's the entire group of 302 and everything that you do for us in supporting Yalde, whether it's financially, whether it's with all the resources that you provide to Yalde, at Grace and Dying. Yossi Smoller, I'm putting together a group of guys to stand and put you guys in the front of the table. Yossi Baumgarten, Beryl Bronstein, Noya Horowitz, Yisrael Megalevsky, Shlomo Litzman, Mandy Willam. Guys, this event would not have been able to become a reality without your help. And I apologize if I drained your cup too much. And second of all, thank you, and all the brachas on you guys kept us. I appreciate it. I'm almost done. Yalde Shluchei HaRebbe is not about one person, it's not about two people, it's not about three people, but we are governed or assisted by a group of three Engelites who give their time, their effort, their energy to make sure that everything is run smoothly. I wanted to give a big thank you to Rabbi Gershon Sabel, Rabbi Yisroel Wilhelm, and last but not least, where is he? Chesky Malamud. I said it last year, I say it again. I love you like a brother, I appreciate everything, and God bless you. Leah Shigalov, she's not here, but this event would not have been a reality last year's, this year's, and all the programs, the sibling support, the retreats, everything that we do. She's our program coordinator. Everything that she does makes what we do much easier. Thank you, Leah Shigalov. He's not here today. He told me he was going to try to make it all the way from Philadelphia, but you guys should know that the last year, Yuri Shemtiv, Rabbi Yuri Shemtiv, together with his father, Avraham Shemtiv, have undertaken a number of initiatives to support Shluchim in their daily lives. And one of those things, amongst other things, is to support Shluchim who are raising children with special needs, and that's why we are all here today. So, Yuri, you're not here, but I wanted to give you a shout out, and if you guys would have any idea the amount of time, energy, and last but not least, actual money, which is going directly to Shluchim, their families, their providers, summer camp, tuition. It's mind-blowing, and I'm grace and dying, and God bless you, and Shem, continue that love and everything that you do. And last but not least, he's also not here. The guy is literally, I'll tell you what, you call a guy, whether he's the head of a mason, whether he's the head of a hedge fund, in between, 9 times out of 10, somebody's going to be there before you to answer the phone. How can I help you? How can I direct your call? But Rabbi Moshe Kitlarski is a man that you have a cell phone number, 9 times out of 10, providing that he's not traveling overseas, he is going to answer your phone call. He's going to give you the time of the day, and he is going to help you in any way that he can. So Rabbi Kitlarski, I know you're not here, but from the bottom of my heart, everything that you've done for Yalde, whether it's with people in Florida, people in Russia, people all over the world, or it's just being there to help us with whatever it is that you can, I want to give you a grace, and I want to give you a bracha that you should have gesund, and and enough tefes to continue doing whatever it is that you're doing for Shluchim and Anash and Lubavitch and everybody in Klal Yisrael worldwide. So this is the time when I make my introduction. I'm exceeding my time limit, but a lot of you guys over here know me. A lot of you guys get my phone calls, my emails, and you take a cup, yaldi, 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 help, 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 help. In a way, it's a very easy job, but there is one guy who every single day, 24 hours a day, is there and actually taking that money and putting it to use. Shelly Weiser is a guy who is dedicated. He's dedicated not just to Yahweh, not just to the Mesid, not just to even the 175 families that we are servicing. In Ganzen Ibrigigan Belayda Nefesh, whatever the hour demands, Shelly is there countless of hours with doctors, with parents, with therapists, hospitals. The guy is awesome. It is my utmost privilege to introduce to you. He's also a member of Hatzalah. With all that. Ladies and gentlemen, not ladies, no ladies here, Mary Rabbi Isai, Rabbi Shelly Weiser.
I think we forgot to thank Double A, so I guess right now we're time to thank Double A. Thank you, Double A. I hope this was the gala of Mitzvah Shlacha B'Fana. Okay. I'm not standing here alone today. I'm actually standing here and I'm representing the 176. Double A is not aware, but last week we had another family that signed up. So we have 176, actually, like Brett Paschke would say, it's a new continent, we opened up a new city. I'm representing the 176 Shluchim and their children from over 20 countries and about 134 cities from all over the world. And I want to thank you from the bottom of my heart for enabling Yahweh to be able to help these families. I thank you for making Yahweh an organization that cares and helps whenever and however possible. But I would also like to thank you on a personal level, on my behalf and on my family's behalf. And here is, I'll tell you why. I'll give you a short class in history, a little bit of a sad story, but I'll give you a little class in history. I was born in a city which in the years 1940, 1943, over a span of 3 years, that city had a hospital called Steinhof. As you can say, it's a German name, you see German name. This city and that hospital, I could speak, had about 3,600 resident children and young adults. Now, over those 3 years, that hospital tortured, dismembered, killed and dissected over 800 children and young adults with special needs. They used the body parts to make medical research. But this is not even the biggest atrocity. The atrocity continued, but after the war was over, the doctors who were in charge of the hospital were not even charged. They tried to charge them, and it was thrown out due to technicality. One of the doctors went on to be Austria's most prominent medical forensics expert, and you can only imagine where he got his expertise. In 1976, my parents moved to Vienna with the Levis Brachas. In 1985, my brother Isaac was born. He was born with something called Trisomy 21. Those that know what that is, it's also known as Down syndrome. As soon as he was born, My parents, the doctors, very kind doctors in the hospital, came over to my parents and told my parents, what do you use this child for? I forget, this is 30 years ago. His birthday was actually this past Sunday. It's 30 years ago, they came up to my father and told him, what do you use this child for? He had four children at home, the youngest one being a wild child, and that was me. And go home, take care of your children. What do you need this child for? We will find you a very nice family to take care of this child. It is too much. Don't do it. My parents obviously said no. And I'm talking from the Eivishta. The Eivishta wanted him to be in our family. And we're going to take him home. That's when my parents started a long and lone journey to raise my brother. And believe me, it was not easy. I spent many hours on the phone later with my parents discussing what happened over the years, how they raised him, why they did certain things. I want them to understand that this I can maybe try to tell over to some other shluchim. It's actually an interesting story that revolves with my brother making a shliach back in the city of Vienna. It's a story I wrote up somewhere and it's not, now is not the time. But my parents went on a long and lone journey to raise my brother. And obstacles came up. Chinuch was a big issue. There was no therapy, there's no doctor. This is Austria, don't forget. Austria had a very dark history with special needs. I forgot to mention before, the body parts that the doctors took apart and put them into different places, Austria did not bury them until the year 2002. So this is a trend. My parents, when my brother was born, they had no organization to turn to, no shoulder to lean on, no one to gain information from. They didn't even know anyone else that had a child like this. In Austria, there was maybe one other girl that had Down syndrome. There was no known children with mental retardation, as they called it back in those days. And even back in those days, to call Israel to find out, it wasn't networking as it is today. It was very different. So my parents were standing alone, and they tried to do the best they can, and it was very, very hard putting them through public school, much against the communities. They didn't believe my parents would do that, etc., etc. But also, us siblings, we also had a big part in helping him grow up. A lot of times I remember going out and having to fight with the neighborhood kids to make sure that they let him play in the games. We had to fight for his rights, etc. And I told you I was wild, they even sometimes became bloody fights. But we got comments that were very nasty. We got comments like, your family is retarded, your family got punished, your family, your brother belongs to Steinhof, that's the hospital I mentioned before, that's where your brother belongs. And such hurtful comments. He's a goy, and a lot of sad comments. So when I was approached by Menachem Mendelkrinsky a few years ago to run Yalde's daily operations, there was no way I could say no. How can I say no when I know that this is what my parents needed, this is what our siblings needed? This Yalde was the answer my parents and our siblings were looking for all those years. I could not say no, and I took it on. And therefore, as I said before, on behalf of myself and my family, I want to thank you for giving my family and my siblings the answer to the question that my parents and us had 30 years ago. And for that, I thank you. I can't thank you enough. Thank you. But as much as I can thank all the people that came and are giving the gufam, the nafsham, and the mainam, is one individual here that deserves a much bigger thanks. And this individual lives by, and he's the epitome of lishma, the word lishma. He never asked for recognition. He doesn't want to thank you, and I understand he never even wanted a reward. All he wanted to do is just to help shluchim, period. Nothing else. It started with There's an individual running around in the Atmos Kodesh, also known as the Catskills, in the Holy Mongol colonies, running around because he found out that it's a shliach that needs some very, very expensive equipment. He ran around raising a lot of money for the shliach. And there was a shliach that needed therapy, a certain therapy called Feldenkrais. He ran around and raised tens of thousands of dollars to cover those bills, and so on. And then he met another individual, which I mentioned before, old individual that the AA mentioned before, Keski Malamed, Israel Warren, and Achmed Krinsky, etc., and the Gershon Table. And they got together and decided something way bigger needs to be done. And as I say, the rest was not history, because Yaldeh is here today and is happening because of you. Rabbi, I would like to ask you to please help me welcome and thank our honoree, Yechiel Swer. Yechiel, because of you, 176, my family and the family of Rabbi Plotkin included, are receiving daily assistance, whether it's financial, whether it's physical. The list goes on because of you. Thank you very much. And over 1,000 siblings around the world that are benefiting daily because of this man right here.
First, I would like to wish you Mazel Tov and Yeshu Koyach to my classmate Avram Elias Plotkin. Nice to see you again after 38 years. Shalom Mishael of Father. It all began with a single phone call. One evening, about 8 years ago, I was speaking with my close friend, Rav Nachman Shem Tov. He had just gotten off the phone with a young out-of-town shliach. With a young out-of-town shliach who was in a major dilemma. The shliach's son was born with a developmental delay and now at the age of 2 was still not developing properly. Having gone to numerous specialists, it was determined that the only chance the child had normal development was by undergoing Feldenkrais therapy, which was both very expensive and available only in New York or California. Insurance would not cover it. After a brief conversation with the shliach, I made a few phone calls and with the help of a very generous donor, raised the necessary funds for the monthly treatments and air travel expenses for a period of 1 year. The child today is 10 years old and is Baruch Hashem doing beautifully. End of story, right? Wrong. A few days later, I received a phone call from a second shliach in another remote location. His wife had recently given birth, and the baby would require numerous surgeries in order to survive. Regardless of all the surgeries required, the prognosis for a normal childhood was not too promising. "I hear that you help shluchim in my situation," the shliach said to me. "Sir, can you please help me as well? The situation is critical and I really no one to turn to," he said. I immediately got to work and was able to raise a respectable amount of funds for this shliach, but nowhere near what he needed. Word travels fast, and a week later, I get phone calls from 2 more shluchim. again, asking for help in dealing with children with severe challenges. I quickly came to the realization that this was only the tip of the iceberg. I turned to my friend, Hesky Malamed, and told him what was going on. He agreed with me that this problem was probably bigger than anything the two of us could ever handle alone. The three of us, me, Hesky, and Mandy Krinsky, we went then took a trip up to Muncie to meet Reb Gershon Sable of Yidei Chesed. His expertise in the area of childhood disabilities is unparalleled. His professional opinion was that based on the percentage of disabled children across the general population, if we take that percentage number and apply it to the amount of shluchim we have worldwide, we can extrapolate that there are approximately 300 children of shluchim worldwide requiring some kind of medical intervention. We then reported our findings to Rav Moshe Kotlarsky, whose love and total dedication to the shluchim is legendary. That's when Yaldei was born. To date, we have evolved into a multifaceted organization, assisting with the various medical and emotional needs faced by shluchim's families. The challenges involved in raising a child with disabilities can take up most or all of any parent's time. Now, imagine a couple out of town on shlichus, struggling to keep their moises up and running, coupled with the challenges of raising a family, plus the disproportionate needs of a disabled child. It affects the entire dynamic of a household, not to mention the resulting shalom bayis tensions. Everyone in the family is affected, mother, father, and siblings. We recently observed Gimel Tammuz. Our Rebbe is a legendary figure, a true leader as described in the Maamar of the Yatzar Tetzaveh, which we studied on that day. The Rebbe totally devoted all of his time and energy to Klal Yisrael and had a very special place in his heart for all his shluchim. Shluchai kelav shel adam kamoiso. Each and every one of the Rebbe shluchim are his personal representatives in all four corners of the globe, giving of themselves selflessly. Wherever a Jew is, whatever a Jew needs, the shluchim are there for you. In the early days of shlichus, when the Rebbe started sending out shluchim worldwide, other Jewish groups criticized us, saying that the shluchim's children will not be able to remain firm in the outside world. The Rebbe guaranteed the spiritual welfare of his shluchim's children, and Baruch Hashem today we see second and third generation shluchim taking up posts worldwide, continuing the Rebbe's holy work. Nisi Hador Kol Hador, Ki Hanasi Hu Hakol. The Rebbe guaranteed the spiritual welfare of all his shluchim's children worldwide. It is our obligation to guarantee their physical well-being as well. Thank you. I received a letter today from a shlucha out of town who benefits from Yaldei, and with her, I have her permission to use the family name. This is the letter I received. Where could the wife, mother, shlucha find the adequate words to express such a deep gratitude for what Yaldei Shluchei HaRebbe has done for our family? Where would one begin when very often our challenges seem overwhelming and our strength fragile? The magnitude of being a parent or sibling of a special needs child draws on heartstrings one hardly has adequate time to prepare for. Emotions that run deep beg to be soothed and comforted, and as shluchim, taking care of these needs are no less an obligation and responsibility parallel to the myriad of tasks we tend to daily. Yaldei is more than a program or organization that supports shluchim with special needs children. Yaldei is the extension of the Rebbe's care and love for each and every shliach and shlucha, each and every sibling and every single beautiful special child. Yaldei is the very core of strength and support, the very propeller that moves us, v'gashmias v'ruchnias. It is the comfort to the wounds of life, the very message of our Rebbe, that we are not alone. Having a child with special needs is humbling. It is the gift of Hashem, with a blessing of a deep appreciation of life, living, vitality, and indescribable gratitude. Yet without a doubt, beyond whichever therapy, clinical assessment, education plan, or diagnosis which come our way, we have been most supported by Yaldei, an extension of family, who miraculously understand the life of Shluchim, our challenges, our heartstrings, and all the different directions in which we are pulled on a daily basis. Thank you, Yaldei Shluchei HaRebbe, where special things happen. Chana Skop, Mill Valley, California.
Good evening, everybody. My name is Yisrael Wilhelm. Yisrael Wilhelm, I'm a shliach in the University of Colorado in Boulder. And I'd like to take this opportunity to thank everybody here for coming tonight, all of your light, coming out, showing support for our shluchim. It really shows us av echad lekulono l'chaim l'chaim, my friends. Thank you. There is so much I can focus on and talk about regarding the support I received from Yaldei, both as a shliach of a child with special needs and as a board member and father, and by the dreams I have for this amazing moisid. One small part of Yaldei is uniting all the parents, all the shluchim together. It might seem very small, but as you all know, when anybody in this room has any type of challenge, the people you connect most with are other people who have similar challenges. And when your own son or daughter are in public school and are friends with Jackie and Jamaica, Fritz, and the only other people in town you can talk to and connect with are their parents, let me just say it simply, it's hard. It's hard for you, and it's not good for the neshama. But having the ability over a kiddush, over the phones, and over the many retreats that Yaldei do to speak to fellow shluchim and to receive the chizuk is amazing for you, for your wife, for your shalom bayis, for your children, for everything. So with that, I would like to introduce a fellow shliach and a fellow chassid who finds himself in a similar situation to me to share some words with us. Before I do, I'd like to take a moment to recognize Rabbi Plotkin from Toronto. You know, in Lubavitch, we don't give hespedim after 120. So for me to say anything now, veredoch. But as a campus shliach, I can share what campus shluchim share when we got nothing else to do, right? Rumor has it, actually, I heard it from the shliach himself. One of the campus shluchim came to the greater area of Ontario, and Rabbi Plotkin himself took it upon himself, not because he's related, but because he knows him, to unite all the shluchim together in Toronto and to support the shliach both financially and emotionally. And it's a beautiful thing. Anyway, you get the picture, Rabbi Plotkin. It's my honor, on a personal note, to thank you for your continued support of our moisid, your push, and your vision on helping us, shluchim, fellow shluchim, 160, 170 shluchim around the world. And as a small token of appreciation, please come up here. We'd like to give you a picture of the Rebbe from Tess Bavado, our customer base. And after that, please, everybody in the room, please be quiet and give your full attention to Rabbi Plotkin. Please, everybody, please be quiet and give your full attention. Thank you.
I don't think so. It's actually this summer that we are celebrating, me and my wife and my family, exactly 30 years of being mashlichus in Markham, Ontario, Canada. But it's quite ironic, 30 years, I got no honors, but I had a special needs child, and Baruch Hashem, here I am being honored by Yaldei. There was a boy, a young man, his name was Shmuel. He came to shul one day, and he was a very meek, weak guy, and they called him up for Hagba. He was very embarrassed. He came up there, he barely was able to lift the Sefer Torah. With his last kofis, he picks up the Sefer Torah, and he's all embarrassed that he couldn't pick it up, he almost dropped it. So that day he decided he's joining a health club and he's going to become strong. And he went to the health club every day and he became all strong, all pumped up, all buff. And he came back to shul, and the first time they called him up, he runs over to the Sefer Torah, he opens 10 panels, and he feels so good about himself. The Gabbai whispers in his ear, "We just called you up for Shlishi." Sometimes in our lives, we prepare for different things. We prepare ourselves for a Shlishis, and we think the Shlishis is going to be simple. But instead, the Rebbeinu Shel Olam sends a curveball, and you end up with a child with special needs. And suddenly it's a whole new story. But I believe that that is part of the shlichus. Not only is it part of the shlichus, but with our little son Zalmi, who's now 12 years old, and next year he's going to have a bar mitzvah, and you're all invited to Zalmi's bar mitzvah. I believe that he is part of that, part and parcel of that shlichus. He is a shliach himself. A couple of weeks ago, you know, when you have a special needs child and you try to make a speech in shul, and for many people that's their favorite part, come specially to hear my speeches. Anyways, so Zalmi is sitting in a seat and he decides to come up to the stage. And he starts, you know, like all kids can do, but especially special needs children. And he distracted me. I couldn't keep my train of thought. I couldn't finish the thought. I felt like a total failure. After my speech, a lady comes over to me, she says, "Rabbi, this was your best speech ever." So I say, "What do you mean?" She says, "It's not what you said, but how you dealt with Zalmi. I learned so much from that. Your patience. You were able to teach me with that much more than you possibly could have taught me with your drasha." Guys in the back, you're going to enjoy this story. So, I want to tell you, Zalmi is a shliach. He's a shliach like all other shluchim. That's very important to me. It was about a year ago, my daughter got married and we had a Sheva Brachas. And I want to tell you about my son Zalmi. He loves, he's very physically fit. He loves to go to the different playgrounds, jungle gyms, you know, different places. Not far from my house, about a 5-minute drive, there is this big playground, massive playground. But it's not in a very kosher place. It's in the back entrance of a Burger King. You guys are eating burgers tonight, so you know what that's all about. But Burger King, for those who don't know, is not a kosher institution. So I didn't know what to do, okay? He asked to go there. So you know, you would you have to do? So I used to send Zalmi with the nanny. We have a helper in the house, send him there. And he used to go there on a weekly or bi-weekly basis. He always asked to go there, and I would take him there. And this was the day of the Sheva Brachas. He asked to go there, so I dropped him off. It came time for the Sheva Brachas. I had to pick him up. The way I usually did it was, I wouldn't walk into the Burger King. What I would do is I would take my cell phone along and call the nanny, tell her to come out. But this time I was rushing because it was a Sheva Brachas. I come to the Burger King, I'm standing there, and I realize I left my cell phone home. And the Sheva Brachas is going to start any minute. So what did I do? I had no choice, so I got out of the car and I started walking around the institution, around the Burger King. I put my face in the window. Who knows what that means exactly? People were looking, a rabbi with his face in the window. And I couldn't see Zombie for whatever reason. I'm waiting, and I know that the oil is waiting for me for the Sheva Brachas. I decide, you know what? I'm just going to close my eyes, run inside, pick him out, take him out, and go home. Exactly what I did. I closed my eyes, I ran inside, and as I walked through the front door, I hear a voice, Rabbi Plotkin! I said, Nikki, what are you doing here? She says, what are you doing here? She says, you won't believe it. Nikki was a girl that her mother was a balas tshuva in our community. She moved totally away. She intermarried. And she had children. And she lost all contact with me. And there, she says, here I am sitting in a Burger King, a trade place, and she knows she shouldn't have been there. And she says, look what's happened to me. I'm married out of the faith. I'm eating trade. She says, I turned to my mother in heaven, and I says, Mom, she says, I said to my mother, if there is a God in heaven, Mom, show me a sign. And in walks Rabbi Plotkin. I said, Nikki, it's almost Pesach, are you going somewhere for the Seder? Sure enough, she came to our Seder, her kids come now to our preschool, and she has become an active member now in the community, together with the children, all thanks to my little Shliach Zalman. And I want you to know more than that. Zalman was not there that night. It was my mistake. I thought he was there. He was actually in another place that my wife had dropped him off. And the second thing is, that after that day, Zalmi never ever asked me to go back to the Burger King ever again. So, go figure. You never know, your children are shluchim. They are shluchim themselves. And that's why I have a little bone to pick with the Moisit Yaldi Ashluchim. But I don't know, Yaldi Ashluchim implies that they are children of shluchim. But emphasis should be Hayilodim Ashluchim. Because they are the shluchim themselves. They're just as much shluchim as we are, but not just our children. But anyways, you can still keep the name. It's a nice name. I know you can't change the stationery and all that. But it's really, the kids themselves are the shluchim. And so I want to tell you, my friends, despite all of this, all that I told you about Zalmi being a shliach, I want you to know, it ain't easy. As much as everyone tells you, Chaim Adreges, and Heichin Neshomis, and you know, people come and tell you, oh, you're so lucky, you have such a high Neshoma. Taka Heichin Neshoma, and the kid is a Shliach, and etc., etc. But it isn't easy. Parents of special needs children go through Shiva Madure Gehen. You have no idea how difficult it is from the moment the child is born. I remember when Azami was born. In the hospital, this is supposed to be a professional hospital. He's born. The nurses give a look, the doctor gives a look, they right away know what it is. Everybody runs out of the room. Like it's a Pesach, Magefa. All run out of the room. And all that's left is the doctor, and I remembered like today. He placed my little boy on my wife's lap after she just had given birth. And the doctor turned to her, he was Oriental doctor, and he says, "Trisomy 21. And with that, he ran out himself. And there we are, left all alone in a room. With a mazel, I went with Yechiel Shward. We went to science together in Lubavitch Yeshiva. So I knew what trisomy 21 was, and it's Down syndrome. But by the way, I want to tell you, I'm so impressed with the other honoree, Yechiel Shward. Let's hear it for him. Yechiel, you're a mamash like a real shliach. I'm so impressed from the good old days of Mr. Lambert's class in English together. Can I know how at least one of us turned out okay? But I want you to know, the first thing that Down syndrome parents experience is isolation, loneliness. Here we thought we were relatively successful shluchim, and suddenly our world is turned inside out. I want you to know also that is an amazing amount of stress and shalom bias. I was doing a lecture for some special needs families a little while ago, and 60 to 70% of those families are divorced. So the statistics out there on shalom bias is mamish terrible. The incredible machlekes that break out in families as a result of a special needs child is incredible. And that's why, ki malach la vitzav alach v'shvarcha. Yaldei Shluchi HaRebbe is God sent. You have no idea what it means to get a little check in the mail, support for your child to go to camp. You have no idea what it means to be taken to a retreat only for the parents of special needs, where they can pour out their hearts, they can talk about their little children, talk about how they have to clean their kids, their 15-year-old boys, to clean their soiled diapers. You have no idea what this organization does. And each and every one of you that's in this room, you have no idea how much you have accomplished by supporting this barbecue and supporting this organization. What you are doing to us, what you are doing to the 170 families, is totally transformational. You are the angels. I want to tell you, Erev Pesach this year, everybody can help. Everybody can help. We had Erev Pesach this year, a young boy called up. You know, me and my wife were going crazy preparing for Pesach and Shlichus and all those things. And a young boy calls us and says, "I want to take Zalbi to our house for a couple of hours." I said, What? You're also making Pesach. Are you taking my kid for a couple of hours? You're also doing Pesach. He says, "Don't worry." And we dropped him off in a flash, like not a problem, right? The way we took him over, it was an hour away, no problem. We brought him over. And I saw that there are like tzaddikim in this world. There are righteous people, people that care. In this lonely world, there are people who actually want to help. I was so moved by this family that helped me out that on the way home I saw a bum on the street who I always pass and never pay attention to him. He stuck out his hand. I put a $20 in his hand because I was so moved. I said, if people help me, shouldn't I be helping others too? The work that Yaldi does is creates a spiral effect, creates a ripple effect. Helping others helps us to become better people, all of us. And Moses, like Yaldi and Shluchi HaRevi, like Yechiel said, they are the symbol of what the Rebbe is all about. The Rebbe is there with us. B'chol tzareisach lo yitzar. He's there with us. He gave a promise for the Shluchim especially, that the kids will be healthy. And so he's there. He's there, B'ashgacha Pratis, the Eibishter is there, taking care of us. He sends us, Yaldei HaShluchim, to be there for us, together with all the supporters in this room. So let us have a round of applause for all the supporters. But I want to finish up. I know a lot of you guys want the desserts. You want another steak. But just I'm going to finish up with the final little story that happened to me. To show you how there always is the Yad HaElyona, Rabbeinu Shel Olam is there with us, the Koichus of the Rebbe is there with us in every moment. A small story. I know many of you are after the days of videos. When my kids grew up, there's a thing called the video machine. And one of the very famous videos, you know, the Babachas, we can't show many videos. One of them was Hand in Hand, and the other one was Living with Rebbe, what was it? You all remember, what's the name of that video? Amachas. So, it's the first one there of Ashgacha Pratis. Everyone remember that when Ashgacha Pratis, that kid that was Mrs. Bas? If you have ever seen it, by a show of hands, has anyone ever seen Amachas? Okay. So there's a story where a little young boy misses his bus, and his Rebbe says, by the way, he says, this is Ashgacha Pratis. Pick this envelope and drop it off at Johnny Hackman's house on Union Street. So the young boy goes to Johnny Hackman's house on Union Street, and he's looking for the house, he can't find it. So he sees a policeman walking down the street, and he asks the policeman, and the kid says, oh, Ashgacha Pratis is here. Come, maybe you can show me where 1311 Union Street is. She says, sure. The policeman says, sure, with pleasure. He takes him over to Johnny Hackman. Johnny Hackman says to the policeman, oh, you're the policeman that helped me with a flat tire. Isn't that Ashgacha Pratis? So the policeman says, it's the second time I'm hearing that word, Ashgacha Pratis. What does that mean? Johnny explains it. Everything is for a reason. God is with us wherever we are. He's directing our steps. And the policeman's all excited about that lesson. He goes out down Union Street. And who does he meet? Benji Stark. Ever heard of Benji Stark? Benji says, wow, you're just the guy I was looking for. He says to the policeman, this African-American policeman. He says, you're just the guy I was looking for. I wanted to thank you for what you helped me out with Bay Swiftery. Closed down the street for us. So the policeman says to Benji, oh, isn't that Ashgacha Pratis? And Benji says, oh, that's the end of the video. But the story doesn't end there. There's an ending to the story. Right after 9/11, I came in with my kids to New York. And we have someone in our community that was killed in the 9/11. We have a family, the name is Glazer. A Mr. and Mrs. Glazer. They were over 90 years old. And they lost a son whose name was Edmund Glazer. He got killed in the second plane that went crashing into one of the Twin Towers. And so my kids, when we went into New York, just a little while afterwards, they said, you know, ground zero, maybe we could go, especially the Glazers. They want to, you know, I could take a picture that I was there, their son died there, whatever. So it was a meaningful thing. So I went with the kids, it was Friday afternoon, it was very late. It was a long line, but we decided we'll go right to the front of the line. And we came there, and the policeman tells us, well, can't you see, sir? There's a lineup of 3 hours going to the back of the line. So I said, well, it's almost the Sabbath, and we're here from Toronto. He says, the people coming here from the whole world. You have to go to the back of the line like everyone else. Well, my kids are looking at that African-American policeman. They say to me, He said, they suddenly recognized his teeth. And they said, asked the guy, "Aren't you the policeman from that movie about Johnny Hector, the kid that missed the bus?" He says, "Yeah, isn't that Hashgacha practice?" And he says, "You guys, you're my friends." Right to the front of the line, and my kids were able to go right through. I came back afterwards, back to Toronto, and I spoke to my community. And I told them, this was a sign for me, that even in your greatest stress, even in your deepest moment of tragedy, at 9/11, in the place where the greatest tragedy in the world is, you bump into the Hashgacha Pratis. You bump into the Hashgacha Pratis policeman. The Rebbe is with us in our most challenging moments. He's going to take us out. He brought to us the Yaldei HaShluchim. And I want to personally thank David Leib Shur, Charlie Weiser, Gershon Shetsegel, 302, and Moshe Kuklarski, and of course, Yechiel Schwerd, my classmate. Thank you all. Keep up the great work that you're doing. And together, we'll all very shortly see the final promise, the coming of Mashiach, the kingdom of Heilam Yameinu Mamash. Amen.
The man in the pink jacket, Eli Schwebel and his dear dad, Rimi Schwebel and the Nazarim, the boys and men.
Thank you. Maskil le dovid, they know?
Put it together.
You don't know anything, so get it out.
No.
Amen.
Lord, we pray. When are you guys tomorrow night?
Makushim oim primulecho Ani yoy ma,
ani yoy ma,
ani yoy ma,
ani yoy ma,
ani yoy ma. Yama ya chorida ya dole makushi moi brimulecho. Ani yoy ma,
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 ani yoy ma.
Hey, Rebbe, Rebbe, Rebbe.